This song, it's called Go Juju Go. When people hear this song, they think it's like a chant for the drummer to play. But in actuality, that song was made as a antagonistic song towards Juju, basically telling him to go home. You know, so it's one of those cases where Juju was playing the drums, you know, about a money situation that the band owed him some money. And he was like, this, you know, yelling from the drums, it's my last night, y'all have my money tonight, I'm going to leave. And Bear would sit on the mic and say, go, Juju, go, Juju, go. Like, please, just go. Like, if you're going to go, just go. But if you ever listen to, I'm not sure if it's the second verse or the third verse of the song, well, Bear actually gives away why he made the song. And he says, pay me now, I will be gone. And I say, go, Juju, go, Juju, go. So that's how Go, Juju, Go to me. You know, when I saw it be made, that was how Go, Juju, Go was done.
Song in the country. I just turned 21. I was feeling good. I had a big show.
Brakes on the bus, brakes on the car. Brakes to make you a superstar. Brakes to win and brakes to lose. But these here brakes to rock your shoes. And these are the brakes. Break it up, break it up, break it up.
Well, I got the baddest 10 bodies. This name changes the color. We're gonna go down here, we're gonna rock the house. I love my percussion. This breaks, baby. We're gonna rock the house. Number one song. It's my birthday. We're gonna rock the house. So we pulls up to the Capitol Center, rolls up in there, you know, the band setting up. So I walk in, you know, sold out concert. I'm going on last, you know, headlining. And I walk up and I see this band playing on stage.
Bring it on now.
crowd's going crazy. I'm saying, oh my God, what's going on here? What's the name of this band? This is a band called EU Experience Unlimited.
That whole experience, man, it's like, you can't find that nowhere else in the world.
You know, because that was like one of the first, party time, with a big major rap artist and a hot local DC group. And you can feel all that chemistry in that record, man. You know, the Congos, the drums, Shorty Chim, and Ula Tony, and myself, Juju. And it was amazing, man. And, you know, Demi Curtis Blow and all that. And then performing live at the Capitol Center, you know. And that being one of his biggest hits, you know, besides the Christmas song or something. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. That's, mm-hmm. That's a beautiful thing.
So that put us, like, in a whole other arena of people.
In 1985, EU was scheduled to appear in the Islands Pictures film, Good to Go.
Good to Go, what they was trying to do is capture the real, and they did everything but that. You know, just capture the real go-go movement.
I need how money. Things, how just going away.
Living in, no in, problem, in the go-go man, world. Take it.
Chill. It was canceled, the go-go music. Because they took that movie and tried to make a drug movie out of it. And it reversed everything that we was told that was going to happen.
And man, I mean, it looked like somewhere in, you know, in L.A., the way they tried to betray the gangs and stuff like that, they spent a lot of money. Man, they spent, it was like $1 million.
Moving at it, I'm fucked back the train. Smoking, still smoking. Look out, y'all, the bomb squad.
This movie was supposed to launch the nationwide movement of go-go and the careers of all the bands in the film. The movie opened to horrific reviews, and by the time it was edited and released, EU had not been featured in one scene of this movie.
And those scenes, them live scenes, that's EU. But I didn't want to be in it, so they edited it and made it look like it was Trouble Funk or whatever. And those were outside our crowd jumping up, all that. See, they, you know that, editing. That's EU's crowd.
So I think in what they could control at that time, their intentions were correct. Whatever the writers or whatever Chris Blackwell came up with as far as the storyline, I think that's when it went off the railing from what the local guys perceived it to be and what it ended up being.
So the only thing that really I could say or anybody I know could say good about the movie was it had a good soundtrack. The bands did good performances.
The following year, EU had been hired to perform at the 930 Club for upcoming filmmakers Spike Lee's birthday party.
Let's talk about what happened.
We was at the 930 Club, not the big one, the little one, on F Street. And Spike Lee was in town promoting She Gotta Have It. And I didn't know who Spike Lee was.
Lee quickly became a fan and let them know it. He wanted them to appear in his next movie, School Days.
He came right to with me and Charles Davis and the band. We was playing Shake Like a White Girl. And he said, wow, I got an idea, man. I want you guys to be in this movie and perform this song called The Butt. You know, I looked at him without, you know, you hear this stuff all the time, being an artist.
And I created School Days like I created dance.
And do tell, what dance is that?
What dance is it? The name of the dance is called The Butt. It's called The Butt. Playback!
Mike was persistent, man. He sent the demo down, and I met Marcus Miller, and one thing, the next thing I know, I'm in New York, like a week later, at the Hit Factory, recording. And they was walking through, and I started putting my gold elements on it. But they had a format, I was like, I wasn't feeling it. something. They let me be myself. So that's when I got Tony got a big old butt shirt, you know, I run blah blah blah. You know what I'm saying?
Go-go song I heard was that.
Ooh,
yeah, but,
oh,
that song. That was a long time ago.
Oh, that was
yeah,
go-go music?
Like, with the hard drums? Yeah. Like,
shit. I heard a couple of them, but I ain't know they were go-go.
Even after it was done, the band members were still skeptical if this song would work.
I still, I'm not lying, God is my witness. I thought the record was going to be all right. I had no idea that this was going to be a monster record. 27 years later, you know, it's still being played. That is unbelievable.
I remember, you know, Sugar Bear and what he meant, you know, and how he was just pivotal in taking the message and really got into a big-time movie.
Martin, Sugar Bear with that bass. It's tough, man. You know what I'm saying? Then when the butt came out, that was so big for the city. They tore the jukebox up with that doing the butt, man. That thing is like classic, legendary material right there. Never get old.
Unbelievable. And I'm grateful. I'm humbled. You know, God is truly good, I'm telling you. I didn't believe myself. I'm not gonna lie. I didn't believe myself. But I'm grateful it is.
The song, Da Butt, was released in 1988. And shot quickly up the black charts to number one. It made it to number 35 on the Billboard pop charts. EU was now signed to major label Virgin Records. The song was nominated for a Grammy and won a Soul Train Music Award for Best Song by a New Group or Duo. Da Butt would go on to be a national hit record and become the biggest record by a go-go artist to date.
That was the butt was probably the most historical musical moment for kids growing up in D.C. By far. I don't can't even think of, the only one that maybe come close is Go Go Live because it was, you know, it was visual, seeing all the people. But as a somebody who wanted to be a musician, a go-go musician, the butt was pivotal for us.
It's unbelievable, man. One minute I'm playing at the Howard Theater, right? The next week, man, I was playing in California. It's crazy. From California to Florida. Florida all the way up to Wisconsin. Wisconsin back to Texas. This record, it was oh my goodness. I ain't never seen so much money in my life. It was unbelievable, man.
But also, like, being number one on the charts with a go-go record, like, across the country. And no one had did it since Chuck did it with Bustin' Loose. But then to see them come around the way and see Sugar Bear in all the hottest cars, you know, back in the day, but still he had the bonsai eating scrapple, you know what I'm saying? Like, that right there is like, okay, yeah, just stay on your grind, stay on your bicycle and do what you got to do, you know, because there is right there. He's showing you, like, it's true. Like, this could happen for you too.
Sugar Bear just seemed like the guy from around the way that was having fun. That you could be out on your block. Sugar Bear to me exudes freedom, you know what I mean? It's no real method, you know what I mean? It's like you could just be yourself. You could be as wild and free as you want. It was probably one of the most inspiring moments because growing up in D.C., a lot of times you hear Go-Go is local, and, you know, people try to set limitations on it. But when you saw the impact as a kid in the sixth grade who just wanted to be in any band, Junkyard Bucket Band. That's probably one of the most inspiring moments that we ever had as kids because it did show us that you can go anywhere with Go-Go.
Airplanes, tour buses, you know, going on radio stations, going on TV shows, you know, City Hall, MTV. You know, we was one of the first groups to do the MTV Beach Party, you know, with Buck Wild and the Butt. Original songs, Hello. Yeah. That's real, man.
I don't quite remember the first time I heard Go-Go, but I do remember our producer, Herbie, coming to us talking to us about go-go and how big it is in Maryland and especially D.C. and how we need to make a go-go record. And he started playing some go-go for me, and of course I was already familiar with some of it, but I didn't realize it was such a big deal in D.C. And we started working on My Mic Sounds Nice.
Yo, Herb, take it from the top. 1, 2. My mic sound nice, check 1. My mic sound nice, check 2. My mic sound nice, check 3. Are you ready?
People knew us, but as you know, DC and go-go, like, you gotta do some DC go-go to get love, real love here. And so we ended up doing Shake Your Thing, which was had a go-go feel.
They don't understand the way you don't mind. Do I wanna go?
Like, I remember seeing a video for Shake Your Thing. Like, you see rap videos, and then in the middle, here comes EU featuring Salt Pepper.
EU later on did the Shake Your Thing with Salt and Pepper, which was pretty much Mass Extension's Happy Feet. So a lot of New York guys would resample other band go-go songs and then incorporate them in other go-go band songs.
When we did that song, it made Salt and Pepper a huge hit in D.C.
You know, to New York was all about making records and getting money.
Takes me back to a period. If I think about EU and doing the butt, or Salt Pepper Shake Your Thing, I think about Spike Lee and doing the right thing in School Days.
Right after that, they had Taste of Your Love.
EU faced difficulty with being marketed and promoted correctly as a go-go band by their label, Virgin Records. On the road, they were constantly booked as an R&B band or as a rap act, of which they were neither.
The problem with outsiders taking our music and making it to where they think it should sound is that when we try to replicate it back home, it doesn't sound the same. You know, slave to the rhythm, play live is totally different than what you hear on the record. I mean, that's just my take on how it's situated.
This was the same problem Chuck Brown had experienced a decade earlier with touring for the song Bustin' Loose, and many go-go bands in the future will have similar issues. Outside of D.C., nobody got it. The go-go was the sound. To add insult to injury, when EU returned back to D.C. after touring, they were not greeted with open arms. However, old fans had accused them of selling out authentic go-go, as well as other bands and promoters were not acknowledging them as a group that could still pack the house.
They had been gone for a little while. You know, after all the record deals or whatever, it went off. They came back with My Asian Ear Puggers. I don't want to call it a novelty act, because the musicianship was still at a high level. He records a remake of
I Know You See Me on the Video.
True.
I know you heard me on the radio.
True.
But you still don't pay me no attention. Listen,
and then he vamped into the bop.
I know you saw me on the radio.
True.
I know you heard me on the radio. But your style don't pay me no attention.
Go-go, he made it DC, which was like the kickoff to Grown Sex. And he was like, when he saw the open, he just ran. And then he made a song called Balance. And it was like, he had never left. Still could record hit records. So it was just amazing to see his resurgence, his rebirth, because that's what it ended up being. But it was still inspiring to people. Like, it ain't no age limit on it. Like, I can get back in the game after doing all that, still come back, and still win. And he's been winning ever since. And that's the most amazing thing about Sugar Bear, is that he finds a way. It's like he has this I will not be denied attitude.
If you don't know your history, get out the game. Because you got to respect history. You learn your history. And you grow from there. Real talk.
The Bus is a classic party song that is played daily all over the world and on radio stations and clubs throughout the globe.
Moment that we ever had in the 80s, because it took us mentally, it let us dream and say we can go anywhere. And to this day, because of the butt, because of the impact it had, we're still dreaming because of the butt, because we still hear, we still know the impact, we still see the impact of it.
Well, now, you know, I'm playing for people that I grew up with, children and their grandchildren. It's funny, man. But they all know my music. You know, they know all that stuff. It's amazing, man. Because I guess, you know, like you just said, the history and being passed down through the generations. You know, and you're right, this is really a unique style of music. Of course, it's not nationally known like it was before. DC is still loyal to our music.
Sugar Bear is like family. His family, my family, they all went to school together. We've done a lot of work together. Having Sugar Bear in the studio and and bringing his ideas and working with me on projects. You know, it's been a blessing. Salute to what the band had an opportunity to do and what they're continuing to do is to keep Go-Go alive.
We have gotten away from originality because everybody's covering everything. You know, everybody, who can play this to the best? Who can play this? That's not Go-Go music to me. You know, it's just a phase is coming in, and I'd be glad when it goes away because the band's going to get back to original music. That's what it might be.
It took some time for EU to re-solidify themselves in the musical world with their core Go-Go audiences. Today, they still perform several times a week in D.C. and are celebrated by the Go-Go community for their efforts in taking Go-Go to the mainstream. EU will continue to stand the test of time.
What gives a lot of bands here in Washington, D.C. the thought that they want to could tour the country and have a number one record, you know, is all due to the success of what Sugar Bear and Juju and Ivan Golf and Kent Wood, you know, and all those guys did with that incredible run they had.
EU has performed with recording artists like Tina Marie, Morris Day, and The Time, Mint Condition, Cameo, and countless others.
Welcome back. It is the classic party jam that still gets feet moving, gets feet in zone. We've got Curtis Blow and Sugar Bear is here.
Show the people in the back. Clap your hands. Everybody up front. Clap your hands. Come on.
That's, and that's the other thing about Sugar Bear. Like, it wasn't no rules. That's just have a good time. That's just how.
DC is party time.
Ow. And he's still having that kind of
want to party tonight.
How
is
that? Man, I'll be looking right here, man. Come on, come on. Man, this man, I'm first class, Juju.
I can't say enough about what he's done for the game, what he is to the game, and what he's going to continue to be to the game. Fast forward to now when he's still here, he still has his mark on the music, and the music isn't going to stop. People talk about the state of Go-Go and say it's in trouble, and they say it's dead. I don't believe it at all, because it still lives here. The music lives because the people live. We have greats, and we have legends, and we have legends in the making. This is our music. It was founded and was brought upon by great people like Chuck Brown and Sugar Bear. This is our music, man.
Milton Go-Go, Mickey Freeman, and
I am Go-Go.
Ow! This is Sugar Bear. I am Go-Go. What?